Hello and welcome to another QuickBooks tutorial with EC QuickBooks Training. In this video, I will show you how to use the group item. Now, how does this work? Well, instead of creating one item that represents several phases of a job, you can create separate items for each phase and then create a group item to include it in your invoice. So, let's see how this works. I have a full carpet installation service where I install the carpet, I install padding, I install tack strips, I vacuum, and I move and replace furniture. So I want to create a group that includes all of these items. So let's go to item, and then new, and then select group. Okay, in my group name number, I want to enter my group name. And I could put a description here. I'm just going to say full carpet installation. Then I can mark this if I want the items that I'm going to enter here to print on the invoice. And I'm going to show you how it looks like checked and unchecked. So I'm going to check print items in group. And I'm going to start selecting the items that I created for my carpet installation. Install carpet. Install padding. Okay, we have two more, move and replace furniture, and a vacuum. Okay, and then we can enter the quantity here. In this case, this is services, so it'll be hours. So I'm going to put 4, 1, and 1. And I do have prices on the items already. So I'm going to click OK. And there is my full carpet installation group item. Now we can use this item in our invoice. So let's go to create an invoice in the customer center, and I will show you what this looks like. And let's just type in our item, full carpet installation, and it brings all the items that we selected and it gives us the total. And let's preview this. Okay, bring this. Okay, see, we checked print items on invoice, so it's giving us the group description with all the items under that. So now let's see what it looks like with that box unchecked. So let's close out of this and let's go back to list, items list, full group, and let's uncheck print items in group and click OK. Let's go back and create an invoice. Okay, it will still appear here, but when you print it, it should not be there. And there it is. It's just the description, full carpet installation with the total amount. And that's how you use groups. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in my next QuickBooks tutorial.